Hello and welcome to yet another Flutter Mentor tutorial. In this one, I'm going to show you how to use ListView and ListView.builder. I'll leave the documentation on the description, and as you can see, there are technically four different options for constructing a list view. However, I'm just going to go over the two most popular ones. Without any further ado, let's just go for it. So before we go back to Android Studio, I just wanted to use the documentation to introduce you to what a list view is. It says right here, it just takes a list of children that are widgets. And this is the important part. This constructor is appropriate for list views with small number of children. Why? Because constructing the list requires doing work for every child that could possibly be displayed. Now, what do they mean by that? They mean that if you have a huge list of children that overflows the screen, imagine there are 100 children, each of them a widget, all of them would always be rendered the entire time. As you can probably guess, that would consume a lot of memory and cause bad performance. And ultimately, it would make the list lag, which would make your app suck. So if you do have a big list, then you go for the list view builder. And this builder builds the children on demand. That means it will only render the children that are being shown in the viewport. If the user can see it, then the child is being rendered. But if the user isn't seeing it, then Flutter isn't rendering that child. So it's much more optimal and uses up less resources for big lists. Just like it says right here, the builder is only called for those children that are actually visible. And don't worry, because it doesn't stop rendering as soon as it leaves the screen necessarily. It'll probably stop rendering right about here, and it won't render anything from this hypothetical point downwards. But let's learn by doing, which is much more interesting. We only have a list view, and so nothing shows up. As I said before, the list view is expected to take children when you know how many children there will be. Essentially, the list view is pretty much the same as a column with a single child scroll view, which, by the way, you can check out the video on the top right to see how the single child scroll view widget works. Now, the only difference between the column and the list view is that the column takes up as much space as it can, while the list view technically takes up infinite amounts of space. And I mean the vertical space, not horizontal. But anyway, as you can see, I created two classes. We'll get to this one in a second. For now, the widget tiles is pretty much just a container with a list tile, and that's literally it. And the reason I did this is because we can come to this list right here, and let me just come this back. And now all we gotta do is use the children property. And of course, I could manually put in a list of widgets here, just like if it were a column. But instead of that, I'll use this opportunity to show you the spread operator, which is pretty much a cool way to use a list in a case like this. Boom. This right here. And this works in the exact same way. And if I do hot reload now, you can see that it worked. Just like we have it right here, it's a container with a color and a list style with only the leading property being used and a text widget. But I want to show you a small detail. Let me wrap this with a column, and now I'm going to save it, and it's completely crashing. And this is exactly because of what I said earlier, that the column tries to take up as much space as possible while the list view is infinite, all vertically. Obviously, when you combine the two, it goes very poorly. But for example, if you just come here and wrap it with a widget called expanded, and then you save it, everything's okay again. And that's because the expanded defines a height for the list view. And if you can't use expanded in your specific situation, then you could use a container to set a specific height. And if you want to know how to do dynamic widget height, you can click the video on the top right. But let's forget all about this and just focus on a list view. Now, this is pretty much what you get with list view. Something cool that you can do and really easy. All you gotta do is come here and reverse make it true and watch the order here, blue and red. If I save it, it'll be red and blue and it will go to the bottom. Just a small detail, but now let's get to the real point of this video, which is understanding the list view builder. When you're just starting out, it can be quite confusing sometimes. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna delete this right here because I don't need it, and I'm gonna delete this list as well, and let's uncomment this one as well. Now I can come here and just delete everything and do .builder. And when you use listview.builder, there are two main properties that you need to use. The first one is the item builder. And what does this property expect? If we do control Q here, you can see it expects a function that takes a build context and an int. And the reason it takes an int is because the listview.builder needs to allow you to work with an index. So that's what that int is. It's the index. So I'm going to call this listview context. so you don't get confused. And this, I'm just going to call it the index. And this is the first part of the anonymous method it expects. Then we use the curly braces, and now we have to return something. And what this function expects to return is a widget. And by the way, let me just show you what this class has. It only has a constructor, that's it. And the list right here uses that same constructor. And other than the item builder, the most important property you need to use is the item count. And let me show you why. Let me delete this. And I'm just going to put in a container here with a color, colors dot whatever, and I'm going to save it and watch what happens. Well, nothing happens because I forgot to give it dimensions, but now watch what happens. Let me restart the app. And after taking forever for some reason, you can see that everything is orange. Now, if it's still not obvious to you what is going on, let me just add a child to this, and I'm going to save it now. Let me decrease the height a little bit so you can even see it more obviously. There you go. And I can scroll this, but so you really understand what's going on, I'm going to add in the index here. I'm gonna hit save again, and now I think it's more obvious. I hope you already know this, but in case you don't, the index always starts at 0. So this is the very first container, and then we can literally scroll forever because that's infinite. The amount of containers created right now are infinite. And just like I told you, Flutter is only rendering what I'm seeing on the screen, which is why it's not being laggy, it's working just fine, and we've hit over 1,000 now. And the reason for that is exactly because we did not use the item count. We did not tell the list view builder when to stop generating a new item. Now, if I come here and I do 5 and I save it, it's just 5 containers. 0 to 4, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And that's the other thing that I really want you to understand. What the list view builder does is it takes what it returns right here, which is this container, and it repeats it the amount of times that you tell it to in item count. That's pretty much what it does. If you want a list of 100 items, you just need to put 100 here. If you want a list of 5 items, just put 5. But like you saw before, when it was just a container with an orange color, all of the items were exactly the same. Nothing changed about them. And that's because what we put in after the return had nothing differentiating it. If you take out the index from here and I save it again, all the items are exactly the same. And that's exactly what the list view builder is for. It's to generate a list of widgets or items that vary when it comes to their index. And let me use this in a practical term. Let's go to this list right here. Let's make it just a little bit bigger. Okay, that's better now. And let's keep the container so we can have a color still. But instead of a text widget here, I'm going to put in a list style. And for the leading, I'm going to put in these names right here. And how am I going to do that? You take the list's name, which is this one right here, data tiles list. I'm going to place it here. And now I use the index right here. I'm using this index to specify which of the elements I want to take the information from. And then if I do dot, the properties come right here, name or a color. Let's use name, obviously. And then for the colors, we literally just got to do the same thing. We type this in, again, index, and dot color. And now in the item count, we know we have 6 items, so we could technically put in 6, but the best thing to put here would be the list dot length, because this way, even if the list changes, the item count will always be correct. And another thing I want to do is on the trailing, I want to use a text widget, and I'm going to input index plus 1, so that we get the real number of the tile. The first tile will be tile 1, the second tile will be tile 2, etc. And now I'm going to save this and watch how it changes dramatically. And on a side note, if this was not here, it would crash, because the list view would keep trying to render more and more items, and then they would come here and see that there's only 6 entries, so how can they create more of that? They can't. But let's put this back and save it. And I'm just going to make the list double with the same info. It doesn't matter. I just want to show you the scroll feature. There it is. There's no problem. And as you can tell, the index does not stay the same. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And this is pretty much the logic behind ListView.builder. I hope this video helps you understand how it works and what exactly it does. And if I were you, I would take the list view and the list view builder and all the other options, and I would just experiment with them. That's all for now. Hope you learned something. If you did, please leave me a like and subscribe if you want to keep on learning Flutter. I wish you a great day. This is Flutter Mentor, and out.